Hi, I'm Suniti Kastigir. My pet name is Rosie. So some people know me as Suniti, some people know me as Rosie. Currently, I am a self-taught artist, freelance artist, plus I'm an art consultant, and I'm dabbling my hand with curating also. I have curated several exhibitions. I also work with, I started my life as an MBA, working for blue chip companies like the ITC, the Taj Group of Hotels, Tata Cancer Hospital Project, and also Tata's. So I'm basically a brand and a strategy and a business excellence person who decided to pursue my passion of painting. Why art? I have had exposure to art since my childhood. I've been inspired by the great European masters. And actually, whenever we go for a holiday, my brother and myself, we just hit the museums and the galleries more than maybe the sightseeing. That passion for, be it the great masters, the Renaissance masters, the impressionist masters, anything, it's there. So I always, and while working, I used to always feel happy when I used to dabble with colors, creative work and all. So one day suddenly I decided that I wanted to paint, and as I believe serendipitously I got myself an art teacher. I trained under him, and that's where my art journey, within a year I exhibited, and that's when my art journey started. And soon in 2013 I decided to quit my corporate world career and I became a full-time artist. But what I realized in this art world, before I talk to you about my art and what do I want to paint and what I want to paint, is that I have this project which is, I call the Heart Project, H-E, then A-R-T, capital R, that is art with a heart. I realized that there's huge, huge amount of talent in our country, but they are not getting exposure. Why? Because of communication, lack of facilities, they don't know where to go. And unfortunately, I might become unpopular talking about it. Very, very senior artists who are established, they don't have any mentoring system of developing the junior artists. So these artists face a huge amount of difficulties of how to communicate and all. So that's where I thought I'll use my brand and corporate experience of helping these artists at how to promote them, how to do the events, teach them how to write their profiles, teach them how to go into the net, how to use social media. Even there's huge amount of talent, but they lack world exposure because of their financial constraint. They have not seen the world. And actually, you get your art inspiration by what exposure you get. So I also guide them to what to read, how to get inspiration through poems, to literature, through films, through travel, how to use the great internet to get to get inspiration. So that is, and what I do is, my Heart Project is, I curate exhibitions where I get a few very senior signature artists who are the crowd pullers, and then exhibit the other emerging artists. When I do the exhibition, proceeds of it is split with it for a cause and also to the artist. So I have done for art for acid victims, I've done for cancer children. Now I have an ongoing project for destitute children and destitute old people. So this is my little ways or baby steps to give back something to the art world. Also, I realized that when I got so much of happiness and peace when I got into art, that there were a lot of people who wanted to learn. Because what happens is, because all of us have a dream, or in our childhood we have dreams of either painting or music or writing or sports, but that all the dreams get hidden because of societal pressure of to conform, of you have to get married, you have to have a career, you have to get education. So people forget that dream. And suddenly there were people who wanted to come and learn. So what I did was that, why not? This could be another way. I got a studio, let these people, be it anyone of any age, of any social strata, can come in to paint for their dream. And also these artists also have a way of earning a little bit of money by training, teaching these, mentoring these artists. So in my studio, I have I don't call them students, I call them mentees or emerging artists from the age of 9 to 93. Can you imagine? I have a lady who's my student's grandmother. She started painting at the age of 92 and she exhibited, she had her first exhibition at the age of 93. And while I was doing that, I realized there are students, these artists are of different profile. They are, suddenly art is becoming therapeutic. I have cases where there are schizophrenia, bipolar, depression, attention deficit syndrome, dyslexia, or just emptiness syndrome. So it's one happy family where we are just painting for our soul and happiness. And what we try to do is showcase their work annually. And I call all the senior artists and they come and interact with these emerging artists. And they get feedback of how to improve their art, and then they again come back to the drawing book. And some of them are actually selling art, and they have become little emerging artists and they have become professional artists. So that is one thing which gives me a huge amount of happiness, and hopefully I can do some more for art and the art world. And as for my art, okay, I'm a very impulsive person and I feel art is something which you cannot be structured. So I'm very moody. I go through phases, and if there is a classical form of art, they say, oh, it has to be this genre of yours. It has to be, if you're drawing faces, it has to be only faces. If you have to draw figurative, you have to do figurative. But for me, I'm still finding myself. I think as our life journey goes, we are constantly in a way process of evolution and trying to find ourselves, be it in the spiritual path, materialistic part. So similarly in my art part, I paint whatever I want to, whatever I feel. So it can be suddenly if I've been traveling, luckily I have had the opportunity of traveling a lot. So if I travel, I see a landscape, I said, okay, today I'm going to do a landscape. Today I'm going to show this landscape this way. But sometimes it is a poem which is inspired. But I do like working with women, women issues and spiritual issues, because that's part of me, because it's a part of my soul and a part of me which goes into the canvas. So my latest series which I'm doing is Invictus. I don't know whether you all have read the poem Invictus. I can read out a few lines of that poem, and I'm trying to depict that Invictus series, because this is a poem which, since it was introduced to me by my mother, and Invictus is a poem which has given inspiration to me and my mother and my brother. And if I can read out that poem, then if you allow me, I'll just find it. Just a minute, sorry.
Didi, nobody is stopping you.
Mm. No, it's, I think you'll have to chop off part of it.
No, you shall. No.
Where is Invictus? Yeah. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may have maybe for my unconquerable soul. That is the word which I'm trying to paint, unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstances, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the budgeoning of chance, my head is bloody but unbound. Unbowed. That my head is bloody, but no one can bow my head. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged the punishment scroll, I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. That is the word of Invictus, that I am the master of my, nothing can hit my outside. So being a female, and I am also a person who is a Satya Sai Baba devotee, and my spiritual path, This is what is it, that it is I'm working for my soul. So when I paint Invictus, I try to paint women of that we women go through huge amount of societal bias and pain and all, but we will not get bowed down by it. We will not be broken. Even if you see the Rajput, when I was in Rajasthan for a workshop, I painted this, I was in Chittorgarh. So I showed fire, that these women were burnt in fire because of Sati and Johar, but their souls are still living thousands of years, and people are praying that they did not accept defeat. And this is what is all us women go through, the fires of society, but we do not accept defeat. And that is what I try to, even with my land art project, I showed that. I had the opportunity of being part of an international land art. So there also I showed the same thing, that women cannot be bound down. And that is what is the series I'm doing. Another series which I'm doing is that how our perspective in life is. In light also, we have darkness. And in darkness also, there is light. I will show the paintings which is there. And so this is the series I'm working. And another series which I'm working on, it's maybe I should share it, that it's the Pieta series, where Pieta, you know, where Jesus is lying, dead Jesus is lying in the heart of the mother. The pain which a mother goes of losing a son. See, in our spirituality, in our history also, it is whether it is Draupadi has lost her son, Kunti has lost her son, it is Mother Mary has lost her son, these great sons of light. So I'm trying to build a life of the pain of a mother of losing a great son. And that is something which I felt, because I've seen. So that is another series which I'm working. So it is female related. Ultimately, I'm female. And so it has to be female related. But also and the spiritual path, which is I'm trying to show of darkness, there's hope. That is what my art is going to be. And similarly with my art, promoting of artists, promoting of also my Art with a Heart project, this also is basically hope that we will not bow down. And that is what it is. If I want to show you, like, this is the series which I've done. Yeah, it's the same person. I made it Android. It could be female, it could be male. It's stripped without clothes, without any hair and anything. That there it is light, but still there is darkness in that person, because it's what is our perception in life. But similarly, that person, there's absolutely black. You're stripped of everything. Clothes, hair, sex, it could be anything. Your gender is there. But there is light, that little bit of light, saying that after every...
The blue color that you have given is light?
Dark. And then here's that little bit of light. When everything goes, suddenly you'll find that there will be light. When you lose everything, you give up everything, light has to come. So that's why I'm showing that little bit of light coming in like this. And there's a light there. But here, there is light outside. But sometimes we have this darkness in our... That's why we can't see the light. So it is your perception of how you do it. So from here, you can go to here. Okay. And the Invictus series, the Invictus painting has gone to Germany. I will send you a soft copy. Then okay. You can see that.
Huh? Sure.
So that you can see that. So this is where I'm trying to show. Like this painting I'm working on. This is work in progress. Here is which I'm going to show. That see, if you see the lighter series, Serene, is that this is going to have fire, and it's that even you burn me, nothing can touch me, the ice. I'm the Buddha.
Oh.
In society, can't burn me. This is one which I'm showing, that I'm going to put a cage inside this. This is also work in progress. That women are in the cage of society.
Oh.
But there's light here, that they will want to fly out. That nothing can stop them, that I'm invincible. So that is the series which I'm doing on. And what else to tell you? Anything I missed out?
No, up till now it has been amazing.
Huh.
It is going to be a fodder for my YouTube viewers.
So you know what it is? I've reached a stage in life where in corporate, okay, God has been very good to me. I have had earned enough. Now as a poor artist, I know the heart. But you know, these without a regular income. But it's time for me. Art has also been is something. It's not always that you have to. It's not consumption of taking. Sometime in life we have to give back. So why not give it back by people send a message to people. Some people give people inspiration, give them hope through my art, and also teach people that it's time to find yourself. Don't get bound by your societal duty and die unhappy. You have to fill up your soul and do something, and also it's time to give back. So I said, then why not merge my art and my seva together and give back to the society? Be it through promoting art, promoting artists, emerging artists, poor artists, giving them a forum to showcase their work, also through art therapy with the people who are with depression and all, and all the other medical problems. I have dowry cases, battered wives who are coming, and for them it is so much of, you know, when their painting is up on the wall, they've been made to feel so small. Suddenly when you see that their painting is on that wall in that exhibition and by chance it gets sold, it's giving them so much of confidence that I can do it, I can survive. And so for that I want to do that and give back something to, and also through art if I can raise some money for charity, be whatever the cause be. I change my cause, but it is for someone who is disadvantaged. If I can work through it, I think I will maybe. And in the meantime, if someone just sees my art and my painting, for me my biggest gift is while they are passing, if they stand, see the art and smile and say, hey, I understand what you are, where you are coming from. And if my art gives me a little bit of gives someone else a bit of happiness, I think that will be the greatest gift to me. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you so much, Didi. Thank you.
It my was grammar great. Was wrong, my English was wrong, everything.
No, it was amazing. English is amazing. The way you are projecting yourself.
Hmm. Okay, another series I said, I think because you come from the US, if I could tell you that, if you can merge it, another series which I did was the Ebony series. I usually paint tribals and blacks, because one thing I realized that I find tremendous amount of beauty. Society calls them, oh, they are large, they are fat, they have big nose, black color. But actually when I was studying abroad, then in the working with the tribals, there's a tremendous amount of inner beauty. If you see generations of society, because of black and because of large build, society has put a huge amount of bias. Plus the amount of torture, and also from a country, it is also economic disadvantage, slavery, mental slavery, physical slavery. Generations have had, they've gone through huge amount of hell, economic disadvantage because of this bias. But when you see them, you realize that they have a tremendous amount of inner beauty and inner dignity. Have you seen the way they walk, way they carry themselves? You would have to see their eyes. They have that unbelievable serenity because of that inner strength, that it doesn't, they go, I mean, compared to the economically developed, the so-called white society, the colored society has always been deprived and made to feel so. So I call that my Ebony series, is to depict the beauty, inner beauty in them. I'll send you the pictures. They're all gone and some of them in different parts of the world. I'll send you the pictures. And that's why I paint their eyes blue or green. Colored people usually not, because that shows a sign of serenity, spirituality and dignity. And so that is another passion, that these are, I really admire those people. I find them much, much beautiful. Then someone who's so white with a beautiful nose or eyes and all that, it is all fake beauty, their inner beauty. So I do see, I paint a lot of these colored people. You know, I paint large size people. I am large, I am fat. But you know, these are the size, because actually to bring out that you don't have to have a perfect body. What is perfect body if there's no inner beauty? So I try to paint that also. I'll send you those JPEGs.
Okay? Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.